And for this, this opportunity that God gave me to come up here and preach, I am a very, sometimes I'm a very shy person. I don't like to preach. But, you know, when God said, when you have an opportunity to preach, you know, you have the obligation to do your work, right? That's what God is the one us to do. I was thinking about the messages in the past, and I have preached this one in the past in our church, and I thought when James, Pastor James mentioned about the message, and I thought this would be a very ideal for us to preach. You know, what is the purpose in our life? You know, we are grown up here. Many of our kids are grown up here in this country. We are wealthy, right? We don't know, many of us does not know what is happening in the back in India where we are all grown up. There's so many people are in poverty. There's so many people are in hunger. But we are in a very healthy life. We are eating all this, you know, so much, you know, rich, you know, fruit, I mean, rich, you know, healthy fruit, I mean, the food we could eat. We are overwhelmed. We always have a leftover. But same way people are in the countries, in the world, the hunger. Are we ever thinking about that? But we are forgetting where we are coming from. You know, when the people are leaving from Egypt, you know, one thing God told them to do, when Moses speak through them, he said, don't forget where you come from. You were in the bondage 400+ years. Don't forget where you come from. Amen. My brothers and sisters, my little ones, don't forget where you came from. We all came from, and back in India, we didn't have, many of us, our parents did not have nothing. But we are blessed so much. And I want to touch by, you know, what is important in life? And be a servant of Jesus. How can we be a servant of Jesus? We have the message, we sung a song, say, he's a greater, he's a healer, he's a mightier, right? But how that apply to me and you? Are we applying that Jesus, he shed his blood at the cross? Is it worthy? He died for you, me and at the cross.
Oh, Jesus, hallelujah.
In the Matthew chapter 20, verse 28 says, he came to this world to not to be served. No, why he came to us? Because he remembered you and me for so long ago. Because of our sins, he gave us an eternal life. That is the main purpose for he came. Boy, our life will be lost forever in the hell. Can you imagine? We are living this world for how long can we live? My wife said, don't say about the death. But we have to remember the death every day of our life. We could be the last day. Today it could be the last day for us. You think you are healthy? No, we are not healthy. We could be healthy and strong and mightier, but we could be gone for an instant. We could be walking out from the street. We could be hit by the drunk drivers. Are you ever imagining those things? We have to live our life, you know, each day and minute by His grace. Amen. Without His grace, we will not live. In my own life, I have faced so many deaths. I traveled so many countries, so many places in the traveling. You know, by grace of God, I'm still live. You know, Jesus is died for us at the cross. You know, how can we be followers of Christ? In order to be a servant of Jesus, we need to be a followers. First step, we need to be followers. When Jesus was in the Matthew chapter 4, 19:22 says, right? Verse 19, come follow me. Jesus said, I will send you out to fish for people. At once they left the net and followed him. When Jesus called those disciples, they didn't care about where they were. They didn't care about their livelihood. They left their net. They left their possessions. They left their wealth. They followed Jesus. My sisters and brothers, he called you and me to serve Jesus. That's the only purpose. He made us to worship him. Are you worshiping him? Or are you just here to make money and live? But he could live for one short minute, four short years of your life, maybe 8 years old at the most, maybe 90, 100. Very few of us live more than 100. But you have to think about the life you are spending in here. It could be your life you're spending here determine where your eternity will be. You know, be a servant of God is, you know, there's a few things we need to think about. There's a four steps. Can you follow me some slides? There's a four steps, you know, to become a servant of God. Develop a servant mentality. How can we, you know, mentally prepared? We need to think our thinking process. We need to reverse our process of thinking. Don't ever be self-motivated. We need to think how God, Christ, died for us. If he had a motivation,